invite you to stand now for today's scripture reading. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly, from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem, and at that sound the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They're filled with new wine." Here ends the reading. Please be seated. On Friday, Natalie and I were driving back from a week with my father in North Carolina. We were driving back, driving what is usually about an 11-hour drive, and we've gotten about 8 hours into it, and we were driving along on Interstate 64, and I realized that something didn't seem right. I said, "I think we missed our exit onto Route 35. And you see, silly me, I had turned off our navigation, our Google navigation, trying to save data. And so we missed our turn. They sneered and said, "Ah, they must be filled with new wine. New wine, you know, that's the stuff that's not been aged. It's new wine. It's not very good. It doesn't taste as good. It gets you drunk real fast. Ah, these people must be drunk." Or as we might say now, they must be on drugs. Or crazy in the head. They sneered at them. This can't be. Last year, a year ago, on Pentecost Sunday, it was early in the pandemic, and there were people who were doubting, some even sneering, about how we could be church. How can we be church without gathering together in person? How can we be church without singing, without choirs? How can we be church without receiving communion from the hand of the pastor? How can we be church without being able to meet for Bible study, without having our meetings in the blue room, without having confirmation class in Sunday school? How can we be church without being able to visit people in the hospital or in the nursing home? And they doubted this. But here we are, a year later, and we are still church. We learned how to be church in new ways. We've learned how to be church through Zoom and through Skype, through email, through text, through Facebook, through video, through live streaming. We learned how to be church by meeting outside. We learned how to be church by using the telephone. We learned how to be church using that old-fashioned way the United States Postal Service. It may have been a little slower, but it worked. We learned some new ways of being church, and we're going to use some of those. We're not going to give up all of those. But here we are on the verge of being back together in some of those ways that we were used to. We're going to be doing those too. And we've made it. But you know, a year ago on Pentecost Sunday, some of you might remember this, I had a table in front of me. That was before I was recording here. I was recording at home, recording the whole worship service. And as I was preaching, I was taking paper clips. And I had these paper clips. And I had spent some time that week, and I went through our online church directory, and I prayed for every single person of this part of the church called the Lutheran Church of our Savior. And as I was talking on the video, I put them together, connected them, saying, we are going to be working through the power of the Holy Spirit. We are going to stay connected. We are going to be church. Dan, we won't get into that paper clip. And then after that day, I put them on the wall behind me. Maybe not everyone noticed it. But what I found is when I tried to move the strand of paper clips around, is that they would come apart quite easily. I'm trying to untangle. They got tangled, and some just kind of came apart, and I'm trying to get them all together, and I lost a part here. And the reality is that over the last year, we have lost some folks. Some have died. I mean, that happens, but some have died in that last year. Some other folks have just kind of drifted away. And we hope and pray that they will either come back and get reconnected to us. The reality is that not all will. And we hope and pray that they will get connected to the church. Maybe it's not this congregation, maybe it's somewhere else, but we pray that they will be, again, connected. But you know what else happened? We gained some people too. There are people
promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Gracious God, you give the Holy Spirit to your church, filling it with many and varied gifts. And the church throughout the world, strengthen us in your visioning and dreaming, that it may discover anew the Spirit's creative work. God of life, your mighty works are too numerous to count. The earth is full of your creatures, living things both great and small. Open your hand and give them necessities of this life. Send your fresh spirit over the face of the earth. God of the nations, at the sound of the front of the rushing wind, people speak in different languages. Proclaimed and heard together your deeds and power. Fill the leaders of nations with your Holy Spirit, so that they may exercise your gracious will in the lives of people. God of faithfulness, you tend to the needs of your people, even the sighs of our heart. Hear those who cry out to you in distress. Restore to wholeness all who are in any need this day, especially Judith, Ron, Joyce, Lynn, Jack, Ruth, Laurel, Brandon, Simon and Sarah, Linnea, Jackson, Sandy, Laura, Roberta, Lou and Kim, Emma, Kim, Grant, Candy and Jerry, Jean, Andrew and Rachel, Debbie, Charles, Lori, Janet and Paul, Maurice, the family of Jim White, the family of Rasha, Becca, Wyatt, Alan, Chris, Dave, and all who mourn Celine, Robert, Tony, Betty, Mary, Dennis, Chris, Marty, Gary, Gwen, Jim, and Jan. God of love, fill this congregation with gratitude for the gifts we have received from you. Renew our ministries, heal our divisions, and open us to the needs of our neighbors. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
Also with you.
Let us share a sign of that peace with one another. Continue with Holy Communion. I invite you, if you have your elements of bread and wine, to take those out now. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us in one body.